Hi everybody, my name's Ashley. I've been doing a channel called Think to Rethink about lining your thinking pattern up with God's word and what he says about you versus what you've been taught and how you've been brought in things that have been put in you that is not from God and opinions and perspectives that are not God's. So I just wanted to get on here real fast because I'm on my way to work. I'm a little late today. I got to go to worship God at the Crowder concert last night, and it was amazing. I got to go with some really great friends. I call them family because they are sisters in Christ. I love them so much. God has put wonderful sisters around me. And my brother, my biological brother, is my real brother, and he's my brother in Christ. I'm so blessed. Like, he is just amazing. I'm so blessed to have him. I'm so thankful. So yesterday, I just wanted to talk about this a little bit because it's really fresh on my heart right now. Yesterday, I feel like we really had to fight to go to this concert. We, a couple months ago, got the tickets. God blessed us with the tickets. And we have been so excited. We've been waiting since like August, and it's October 20th, the concert. So we were so excited, right? I felt like yesterday was very hard for us because many of us struggled yesterday with obstacles that we had to overcome to get to the concert. And God gets the glory because we made it to that concert and we fought. God's grace is sufficient, and when we are weak, he is strong. Let the weak say, I am strong, the Bible says. We made it. So we had car trouble. We had miscommunication with arrangements for children. We had just everything came up all the way to the parking lot until the front door. Like, everything was against us. The odds were against us. But we fought. We kept pushing to get in and to go and to get there. And we did. We got there. And after the concert, I didn't get home till 2 o'clock in the morning, but it is okay. We had a great night of worship, fellowship. I believe that there are breakthroughs coming, deliverance, healing, just the next level in our walks with God for all the individuals that attended with me. And I know for other people, God has ministered and broke things off and done wonderful things because he's God. So I just want to tell you guys that when you're having hard trouble, when you're going through something, when something feels, when you know something is right and you know God's called you to do something, whether it be reach out to a person for to help that person, for encouragement, kind words, things that person might need, whatever it may be, there is going to be obstacles, especially when the prize is so rewarding and the prize is something that you need to do. Like, you need to praise God. You need to praise God through it. You need to remember who he is. You need to remember his faithfulness. You need to remember his love. You need to remember his great plans that he has for you. You need to remind yourself that no devil in hell can stand against what God has for you. You need to focus on God. You need to focus on him. Because the circumstances is always going to be there, right? Whether they're good, whether they're flowing, whether they're bad, whatever it may be. But what is your focus going to be on? Your focus, if it's on God, then all the little things around you are not going to make you weary. It's not going to hold you back. You're going to be able to pursue who you are and what God has for you fully. You have to push through. You have to remember what you're doing. Who is the author of it all? You have to remember what God has for you. You have to remember his promises. You have to remember who you are in Christ. And you have to praise and you have to worship who he is. And you have to, you just have to know that he has better. And that you may be going through something. You may be having something really bad in your life right now going on, or you may have an obstacle that you are to face to get to your plans that you made. But guess what? You have to push. You have to fight. You have to fight the good fight. You have to fight. So the Bible says also that the flesh is weak and the spirit is willing, right? And in the contrary, they're going against each other. It's a constant battle between the flesh and the spirit. So when you feed your spirit will be more powerful. You'll be equipped with the things of God, and it'll be fresh on you. It will be just right on you for you to fight your flesh. So that means, I mean right on you, by the awareness will be right away. So when something happens in your flesh and you're about to react in a certain way that is not godly, that God doesn't want you to react in, the Spirit will pinpoint it right then and there. The Holy Spirit will. And you'll be strong enough to see that, to be aware, to fight it right then and there and repent and turn from it and do your best to not participate in the flesh, what the flesh desires. You can cut it off. You can turn from it. So I just want to let you guys know that there's always going to be obstacles to overcome in life. And the higher that you go, the deeper you get with God, the closer you get to God, the more obstacles are more harder. There's harder and harder obstacles for each level. You get, a lot of people say, a whole new level, you have a whole new devil. And it's more harder than the last test or the last obstacle that you had to overcome, the last trial. But guess what? It's possible with God. All things are possible with God. So I just wanted to tell you guys that if it wasn't for all of us, five of us was in a group last night. We all had our own thing that we were going through, and we could have just gave up and just stayed home, but we didn't. We fought and we got there, and it was so worth it, being in the presence of God. And we're in the presence of God wherever we go, because God is with us wherever we are. He's with us all. But whenever you're in a room filled with children of God, it's so powerful. It's so powerful. It is so powerful. So yes, being around other believers, other children of God, is very important. You need a community. You need that. It keeps you directed towards God. It's so powerful. You need believers in your life. They're like mind of Christ. They have the same spirit, believers do. So then you guys are going in the same direction. So it's very powerful when you guys are in a room and you're praising the Lord and worshiping, and it's just amazing. I just wanted to tell you, whatever you're facing, God is with you. Sometimes we're being tested. The teacher is always quiet during a test. So God may be quiet. You may think that he's not there, or he doesn't care, or he's not helping you, or he left you, but he didn't. He is there. He is patient. He is kind. He is loving. He is faithful. He is amazing. He is love. God is love. So he is there. So you need to just breathe and face the obstacle that you're going through, but with God. Remind yourself who God is, who God says you are. Ephesians 1, chapters 1, 2, and 3 are amazing. It tells you who you are in Christ as a born-again believer. Please, I encourage you to read it and just take it in. Just take it in. And then whenever things start to come up and stuff, remind yourself how God sees you, who you are, and just receive his love. And then you're able to give his love. I just want to encourage you guys, just focus on God. I love you guys, and I am so blessed, and I hope this blessed you, and I love you guys. Until next time, have a great day. Bye.